Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to game two between eHome Kings and DK here in the ESL One China qualifiers. This is a preliminary match, blah blah blah, in the brackets. So the winner of this best of three will move on to fight Tong Fu in the official round one. And yeah, DK already won game one. Took them more than an hour, but they were able to bounce back from an early game that wasn't really in their favor, but eHome weren't able to break the base as well as DK did in the end. So they take game one, and now moving on to the draft of game two. My name's Dragon, dropping you this game with hopefully less technical issues than before, and I'm joined by Ryu, trying to pick up the slack here and helping me out. So welcome back, man.
Oh, it's good to be back. I've had this same bug that's been really annoying me, and I don't know if I should report it. I guess I'll just complain about it, and then maybe it'll get fixed. Where it's you're minimized from the game. They start the game, and then when you try to click back in the game, it crashes your Dota. I don't know if it crashes your Dota when everyone else is already connected, and then yeah, because it happened last game too, and it happened just now, where I have to restart.
At least we
Yeah,
all can
I'm
blame
just
Reborn
putting it
together.
out there for somebody to fix it. I mean, it's just,
Now someone will go on Reddit eventually and yell about it, I guess. But yeah, at least we can all
Reserve's
blame Reborn
on.
together, and at least I'm not alone with the woes of this new client. I mean, it's great and all, but it still needs some fleshing out in a lot of departments. But yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there. But yeah, draft actually not going too quickly this time around, so they're using the bonus time for the first pick already, with the Earthshaker and the Gyrocopter banned out,
Strong
Bounty Hunter and the
spirit.
Lushrak banned on the side of DK,
Valiant
so
team pick.
didn't particularly like playing against the Prancing Pony. But they give away the Storm Sword here. It's gonna be the first pick for eHome. But of course it leaves a couple of other heroes in the pool, like the Tusk here, picked up immediately by DK.
Valiant team
Anti-Mage,
pick.
of course, also in the pool, one of the better counters to Storm Spirit, so they're probably thinking about picking that up straight off the bat as well.
That'll be
So.
interesting to see what they want to do here. Like you said, that Tusk always fun to
Oh,
watch,
yeah.
but
Not fun to play against
it's
for sure,
Lina.
but it's gonna be Lina instead, so a little bit more
Your
standard
team
still, even
pick.
without the Earthshaker to get. Even not picked up with the Earthshaker, it's still a good enough hero just because it's so flexible to use as well.
You know, I like to see the Lina Earthshaker lanes. I mean, those are okay. You could see it maybe this game too. Lina Tusk could get a lot of work done. If you just get anyone isolated, normally they're just gonna die. It's
10 seconds
if you
remaining.
have it's really easy to combo if
Spirit
you get some
Reaper.
blocks off too. And
Fire
whoa,
team back.
Spearbreaker finally! Yeah, no, I hate this
Yeah.
hero. I hate this hero.
Really? Why is that? Why do you hate Spirit Breaker, man? He's a lovely
It's
space cow.
just so much luck.
It's
It's
only
like playing against
70%.
an axe, 1v1 middle. You
10 seconds
just
remaining.
do luck. It's all luck.
It's only
Yeah.
70%. Come on,
5
man.
seconds remaining.
Calm your
I mean,
face.
there is positioning factors when you're in the off lane and how well you can do, but the hero is
Fire
really
team back.
tanky and it's great for dealing with a hero you were talking about, Anti-Mage, and it can deal with. It just helps them so much when you have a hero that can constantly charge around the map
Radiant
and look at
team
people.
back.
Now, this game, it's not that great against Lina or Tusk unless Lina already used her spells, or yeah, Tusk has used his spells because they can just stun to stop the charge, or you can use Snowball
Radiant
onto
team
something
pick.
and then you'll dodge the charge.
Yep. And then you have a potential for a quick turnaround, and if you can get that, especially if you can get the Spirit Breaker to charge like under the tower, if he feels a little bit more daring, right? Then you can use that snowball to turn around quite effectively. And usually the snowball is not the best escape because you usually have to roll towards an enemy, so unless there's a creep wave behind you or something that you can roll to,
10 seconds
you're still going to die
remaining.
if you're caught out. Just delaying the inevitable, but if you have a
5
teammate with you,
seconds
like the Lina
remaining.
here, to get into the snowball with you, then a lot of options are coming
Reserve
just from this
time.
one hero named Tusk alone, right? Yeah, interesting bans here once again. Techies banned out by DK, so they just hate that hero, and I applaud them for it. Now there's still the option for that Anti-Mage. Question is, do they want to want to just take the fact that Spellbreaker can annoy him a little bit if you don't have both supports in the lane to zone him out. Or do you pick him up anyway, just deal with that?
The biggest problem still is they can also go Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker and Spearbreaker are really good combos when they're put up. So picking an Animage this early can be bad, but it also could be good. If you can get the space for the AM, then yeah, he can carry. He's decent against Storm Spirit. I think there was a... I'm not exactly sure. I think it's like 65 to 35 where Storm Spirit wins in this patch against AM. So it's a little bit misguided to where people think that Storm Spirit has a disadvantage, but Storm Spirit's really good for picking off Anti-Mage before he gets his Mantis Style, and even after he gets a Mantis Style, if he has those, if he can get, you know, a fast Lincolns to counteract the AM's ulti, or if he can just get a fast Orchid, Bloodstone, plus one item, like a Shiva's, then he can kill the Anti-Mage and pick him off with another hero. It's really effective still.
Yeah, that's true as well. It comes down to how well you get the angle. I mean, if you want to kill off an Anti-Mage, obviously the earlier the better, and Storm Spirit peaks much, much earlier than the Anti-Mage usually does, then you still have to make sure that you can lock him down for long enough for him not to be able to blink away. So it's definitely possible to deal with him. But at the same time, there are other heroes that would also work well in this draft here for DK. I mean, especially with the Dazzle now as well, you can go for a little bit of minus armor strat, go a little bit YOLO for something like a Slaughter. Or any other sort of hard right-clicking carry, like the Klings once again.
Ooh.
But the Zeus, maybe not the best now. So you have that inbuilt true sight for the Klings.
I should ban Bloodseeker here. I'm not saying they're going to pick Bloodseeker last, but Bloodseeker plus Zeus saw this combination earlier with Toby. It's really annoying to deal with, and there's a lot of squishy intelligence heroes. Dazzle, Queen of Pain, Lina, and Tusk. He's susceptible to the damage too. He's a bit tanky, but no Spirit Breaker.
Interesting to see what these teams make with the last picks and bans. There's still plenty of bonus time left, so... That Bloodseeker, it's kind of hit or miss sometimes, but if you have that kind of combo available to you with the Bloodseeker Zeus, which would put... would that put the Zeus in mid? Bloodseeker in one position? Storm Spirit offlane?
No, it'd be, that's the next it'd question. Be Zeus, would, how that land it? It'd be Zeus Spiritbreaker offlane or Spiritbreaker support, and then Lion top with Bloodseeker and Storm mid. The problem is Storm could have a rough time because Queen of Pain is really good against Storm in this situation. Lina Tusk might be going in the offlane right now. And then, let's see what DK want to do. They probably need to get a carry. How greedy do they want to get, though?
It's a question. The Klings has been banned out, so they won't have that available to them. It's probably going to be... it's still going to be the Anti-Mage, so... I was going to say probably someone that can also utilize minus armor and slash plus armor from the Dazzle quite well in later parts of the game, but... yeah, they go for that AM.
DK burning!
Yeah, not quite, but maybe they can start jumping in his footsteps with that. But yeah, he can work well against Storm. He can also for Flatterson's face. You discussed that earlier. Also quite nice against Zeus if his spells run down. It's also a lot of mana pool to bring out. And also Lion even. I mean, Lion works through his own mana pretty damn fast because he's kind of designed around that idea of mana drain to get him back up quickly. So it's might make a good target for that ultimate to just burn away, but there's the Bloodseeker that you were talking about, and that can make things extremely dangerous, not just together with the Zeus and the Storm, but also against Anti-Mage in general.
Like, every single hero they have kind of counters Anti-Mage. You have Zeus, who can set up things by ulting, get vision of everyone on the map. Bloodseeker just ruptures him. He's forced to either TP away, so he loses a lot of farming time, or Spiritbreaker's charging him and he's ruptured. And if you get bashed and then ulti, you take so much rupture damage too. Storm Spirit's going to be all over the map too. I mean, it was a no-brainer for me to ban out last for the Bloodseeker if they really want to pick Anti-Mage. But they have Dazzle, though. Like, that's their one fallback. Dazzle, Shallow Graves can make some big plays this game, and we'll see if he can.
Yeah, Dazzle. They'll have to rely on them, and also a little bit of a... some space creation from the Queen of Pain, right? Just make sure that you get the ball rolling before the Bloodseeker can, and that's kind of one of the ways to deal with him. Just keep him low, that he doesn't really have an impact as a hero. Same for Spiritbreaker, really. I mean, if you pick a Spiritbreaker, you kind of expect to be able to charge across the map, put on so much pressure that either you get kills, or you just make the enemy team back off from the lanes a little bit more than they want to and restrict their farm that way. But that only happens if you're scary enough. Right? If these heroes fall back behind early, then I think DK has a decent lineup to take the initiative themselves and snowball off of that, essentially. Would you agree, or would you say that Eholm can fight back no matter what with the Zeus, with the Storm?
Yeah, I don't think you can ever count out Storm. What we've seen, like, last game, he can get shut down really hard. You just get that Bloodstone and get a few kills here and there, and I mean, it's, yeah. All the snowball is up. They have four heroes. Oh, the Lion.
Going in deep here onto the Dire side, that should be nice stun on everyone here, but that won't help him too much. That's the first blood, but a couple of other heroes are back as well. 3-for-3 now, Sandy Mage baits out, nice little good play. Lightstrike Array as well, but Boboga and XSS, they're both falling very low. No charge available thanks to mana. Now, yeah, she turned it around onto Dog. Anti-Mage comes back in. There's Snowball as well to keep them safe. And that's another one down for the count. And now, Piao gets a nice little remnant off. A lot of damage from that, but to pick up the Tusk. But do they lose the Storm Twin for it? And yes, they do. Double kill for the Anti-Mage. Straight at the beginning. Doesn't have a TP out, so he will...
Suicide. He's going to suicide
yeah.
for the group.
Yeah,
wait, is he ate a Tango? That is not the play.
It's one more blink in him, but right now he's walking to the top lane. I'm not quite sure if that's his final destination. It's like the quickest way to get back. I mean, just purchase up some boots and be done with it. No, he's actually working his way to the top lane here. Being followed by Luobo on the Dazzle, as well as Boboka on that Lina. So this is an aggressive tri lane. They're putting a pressure on this Bloodseeker, who's all alone right now with the Lion in mid, placing down a ward, being spotted out by the Dazzle, though. She's not placing the ward yet, so... Interesting place right now. So that leaves the Tusk, for the time being, alone in the safe lane, up against an aggressive dual lane with Zeus and Spiritbreaker.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to see how this works out. It's kind of looking good for the Zeus here. I've been noticing this more. The Zeus always goes for the Lightning Bolt. I guess the static field isn't really that good. You can always deward all Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker, don't die, bro. They don't have any stuns besides Lina's, but still.
So don't have a slow from the Dazzle.
You can always body block. Like, say the Anti-Mage blinks and body blocks and gets in range for the Lina. It could be another easy kill.
Not exactly easy to execute, though. But then again, it's like a low-risk kind of play, right? Because the Bloodseeker is still all alone up here. What's he really going to do? If you go on him, he has to walk away at this point. He also has to be very conservative with his Blood Rage. Because normally that's kind of the spell that makes the Bloodseeker just be able to stay in lane forever. Just get a couple of last hits and you're never going to be harassed out.
Yeah, because of that early action, it really hurt the Storm Spirit. I guess early game, he wasn't able to get the rune. And yes, this is where Queen of Pain can play really aggressive. Ooh.
Oh, wow. That middle lane, the self will be popped. Piao doesn't actually have one, has another Tango, and has to ship a self to him as he does not have a bottle.
Oh. Yep, Queen of Pain did just pick up her bottle too, so this is not good. But is the lane push? Nope. Yeah, a little bit. So that could help the Storm Spirit a little bit, but with the lane being pushed like this, it also could mean that Queen of Pain can dive easily, and she's going to be bottle crowing now. Nice.
Alright, so Eholm Kings are now putting both the Lion as well as the Zeus up top here to try and help out. There's a stun onto Bloodseeker, they're going to try and harass him a little bit more. as the creeper is pushing on a tower. So, what Trident do you actually like better here?
I mean, they have Grave to fall back on. But if they get low and then the Bloodseeker can start kiting around, he kind of needs to go to the side shop and get his boots. If he could do that, that could help out a lot. I wonder what he's saving for. Yeah, it kind of looks really good for DK besides the Bloodseeker getting max movement speed. I don't see what all a Lion can do. Sure, he has a stun and a hex, but it's nothing compared to Alina, where you could just burst down the enemy. You have good range. Dazzle has a good heal and a good save.
And at Zeus, I mean, sure, he provides a little bit of damage, but level 1 for both of the spells is not actually all that much, especially considering the heals from the Dazzle we were mentioning. So, stun will miss on the Bloodseeker, and it's his luck, because would have taken quite a lot of damage if he got hit by that. Yeah, he's being zoned out there, but even so, he actually still has the last hit lead. 24 as opposed to the 14 now of the Intermage. I think some of those were camp creeps here, the small kobolds, but still. It's not being shut down as much as he maybe ought to be.
Alright, well, Storm can go down any minute here. Probably want to keep him at there.
Oh,
there's
a Link. Oh, hello. That was level 6, but now the turnaround, maybe. Lion comes in. As well as the charge from the Spirit Breaker, no further blink available for another couple of seconds here. Double teleport comes out! It's Booboka here! He does get hexed up! Can do nothing to help out a mid. Is that actually good for Ehome or is that good for DK? I mean, they get an initial kill on their mid hero, but then they lose that set hero again.
I think it's good for... I think it's about an even exchange. Thorn Spirit's still going to be having a rough time in mid lane. Is getting crushed in the mid CS as well as the levels. So I think it's really good that Queen of Pain just killed him there, hurting him even more. Oh, bottom.
Yeah. Oh, why? Charge? Was it actually cancelled? Oh, he just started charging, but didn't really go far, and that means that one last Ice Shards will actually pick up the kill. The fight started here with XXS just being charged by the Spirit Breaker, and they tangled a little bit, but didn't quite expect so much damage to come out. Yeah, now Black rotating down here. I feel like they've done all they can in the top with the defensive setup that Ehome is running. Weren't going to be able to pick up many more kills. Instead, they're trying to secure some more farm for Black. I mean, he's got these two kills in the beginning, but he also still needs many, many last hits to get to that Battle Fury.
And they weren't really able to stop or slow down the Bloodseeker at all. And that's where it's not good to go aggressive if you're not really shutting down the enemy carry, but it's a Bloodseeker. He's going to have a lot of bonus damage. Movement speed is going to be hard to charge mid.
Yep. He's got spotted out though. Now Blink's back. The charge still continues. There's a snowball down to the low ground. They do get Dark Louvre coming in from the back to try and help out. There's the Light Striker landing. And that should be a dead. Yeah, that is a dead Spirit Breaker with the Tusk showing off that punch again. So mistakes were made. And actually a little bit lucky as well. That's... lucky in air quotes here that DK was setting up for a gank of their own, plus the two Observer Wards that they put around this middle lane, so they were really prepared for these kind of ganks. After the last pick of the Queen of Pain, nice little blink up to the other side, towards his teammates really, across here, and Spirit Breaker not cancelling their charge, was his downfall there.
Yeah, I'd say DK's early game is really good for the amount of burst damage they can do with the magic. Oh, Courier's
go
nice.
Again. Speaking of burst.
Ooh, nice.
Courier goes down. That was... Oh, wow. I see YK. There's a charge coming out of him. Can I actually bring him down? There's another blink in another couple of seconds. There's the ultimate and the follow-up stun from K. So that'll be enough damage. So once again, make a trade out of it.
Courier for your kill. Lion's getting closer to level 6, however he doesn't have the courier items. I guess it's... I don't know. It's 1,000 gold, but you're giving EXP over to the supports.
And those supports that don't necessarily find that these kind of levels early on, especially Lion, he can struggle with that. If you get him off to a quick level 6, then the Finger of Death, if he mentions his mana correctly, can... Oh, hello. Zeus, a little bit too far forward here. I'm not quite sure what he thought was going to happen. Does get picked up, feeding another kill towards the anti-mage. Doesn't have too many last hits, but with the kills that he's got, he's actually sitting on top of the net worth chart here, 400 above the Bloodseeker even. And that should be a fairly good timing on that Battle Fury. At the same time, Dark here comes out of Inverse here, and the follow-up stuns onto Boboka. They're gonna burst him down. Nice little pick-off there, and meanwhile on top, Snowball comes out onto the Bloodseeker, just standing there, and there's a punch, and Queen of Pain. YCYK helping to make sure that kill happens. Dazzle's the one picking it up, actually, so... Action all over the map now. 8 and 5, only 9 minutes in. Now the Anti-Mage. He's all alone down here, might get gone on next.
Yeah, Bloodseeker should maybe TP down. He just got a Midas recipe, so they're kind of like, hey, we're not going to go for that quick blade mail rush. Oh, there's a charge.
But Boboka, see, little do they know, he will cancel Dark's ultimate. And now the mana being blown out barely does not get the ultimate off. But there's another one coming in. YCYK hexed up. Dark 7. Now hit with a Mana Void just to stop the teleport and bring him down. So, DK, good game sense here. They figured out that something was happening and Black would make a prime target for everyone that's missing on the map, and they are ready with the turnaround.
Like I said, last game MVPs was kind of the support play. Now you see there, nice. Lina baiting out, and if he had gotten another strike off, could have been problematic, but easy turnarounds, and this is what you want. Like you said, he might not have the most CS in the world, but he's 4-0 already in this game on the anti-mage. Just too much space right now.
So has to persevere, about 1600 gold away now from Battle Fury. A little bit less. So it's shaping up to be like a 13-14 minute timing. And Ehome, yeah, they're looking for more of these pickoffs. They're looking to make that Spirit Breaker work. So far it kinda has, but it kind of hasn't. 2-4-2 is his score. But yeah, that Stormspirit though, do you feel like he had... Oh god, speaking of Stormspirit, he's gonna get bursted down. Just gonna say, do they need to make more use of him? Not just a Spirit Breaker to ensure these kills.
He kinda needs to spend his gold. He saved up 1200 here. I mean... Yeah, he's gonna go for... I would like to see him get a Magic Wand really fast in this game. Especially when you're going against Queen of Pain. And then you could still go into the Soul Ring. I think the zip away is going to be very crucial. He's got treads now, can help him maybe survive a little bit. My biggest problem though this so far this game is just the Bloodseeker has been very inactive, and the whole point of your draft is to kind of counter out the Anti-Mage early on by ganking him constantly.
Yeah, he even went back for the Midas here, and it's not really conducive to that kind of goal, is it? You're playing a farm game with an anti-mage who's gonna have a good, well-timed Battle Fury. Is that the way to go here, or...? Oh god, bottom lane. You know JDH playing that Zeus. Regrets coming here, losing half his health and mana, but nothing further will come from it right now.
He kinda needs to get his Soul Ring, I think he's going for that right now. But Zeus did just get his level 6, that could be the go time that they were hoping for. And...
Well, looks like they agree with you. The smoked uphill going towards that bottom lane. It's Dire Ward spotting out that no one is actually farming these jungles right now, but they don't know where the Dazzle is. He's sitting right behind Black, ready to help him out. This is a low probability kill, and with teleport reactions coming out, they might even die if they go for this. Instead of shifting their focus here, they do see the task being charged up, but he's closest here too, Boboka right next to him. He's still gonna go through, the double teleport comes out, and the turnaround. Tusk gets a snowball off here after the Finger of Death, and the nice little Sonic Wave for 3 heroes here! That's just a disaster to borrow from Toby here, 3 heroes down, Piao, not long for the world either here, doesn't have too much mana left in the blink after him from YCYK, who even has a double damage rune. That was a triple kill for the Queen of Pain, now taking a net worth lead, and 4 heroes down in total on the side of Ehome. And
that's
I really have to question the decision to go through with that gank right next to the tier 2.
They're feeling so pressured of how bad their early game was that they're making, you know, kind of questionable decisions. Like you're saying, and then when you make those heavy commitment dives, it just sets up easy counterplays. Like, if Quap doesn't get charged or Anti-Mage just doesn't get charged, it sets up those heroes to make the big plays. And that's all they really have going for them right now, it seems like, is a Spearbreaker charge. But, yeah, mid lane, they could be baiting out. Maybe that's what they need to do. You saw how Lina kind of baited out the Anti-Mage in bottom. Maybe they need to bait Storm Spirit with the Lion, because playing that aggressive, it's, I think they just missed their window, and they can't do that anymore.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of the two-sided sword there with the Spirit Breaker, the double-edged sword, that's the term I was looking for. I mean, he has to be scary to make these kind of ganks work, and kind of not that scary if you're charging in pretty much alone up against a tier 2 with teleport reactions at the ready. Two heroes already there, so they kind of picked him up, they kind of had a lot of time to just care about the Spirit Breaker before the rest of the EOM was able to come in and help. And it's kind of the problem. He doesn't have the item progression to be scary, right? To be a Spirit Breaker charging you.
And to I make mean, that it's not been a, not scary 14 proposition. Minutes in the game, and there hasn't been one rupture. And there's been a lot of charges, but they haven't synergized anything.
Yeah, that's the other story. Middle tower is under attack. Dead Bloodseeker. I mean, he's farming well, but now there's a teleport coming in with engagement in the middle lane. YCYK gets the blink out, though. But did he? Oh, it was ruptured, I believe.
Yep.
Died because of that. Barely got it off in time, so yeah. They're listening to you, man. They're listening to you.
Hey, you never underestimate Spirit Breaker constantly charging around the map. That's the one thing. They still can get back in this game. Storm Spirit just needs to get some items up. And mid lane. Ooh. Yeah, oh,
wow. I did not catch that, unfortunately, but it was nice little pick out there as well. If I'm a little bit out of it, I'm still checking whether my measures actually worked and keep the frame rate stable, and for now it appears so. So we can breathe. We can breathe deeply, or at least I can.
Well, Ehome can't breathe. DK Black Z just finished up his Battle Fury. Say nicely timed, 15 minutes and 30 seconds. Yep. Really well played, 4-0 so far. Need to figure a way out how to shut down this AM now. That's their next goal. Yep.
The timer starts now. Make that Battle Fury. Won't be long until he has Manta, Vladimir, something like that. And yeah, they do spot out this line here. Places a ward. Still has a Haste Rune, but being knocked down a little bit. Charge comes in as well onto Black, though. Can they lock him down? Not really, with no extra help. And now the line caught on the wrong side of the river. He's gonna get die, and Dark 7 tries to teleport out, but the burst damage is enough with the ice shards from the top, so they get two heroes for free. They might have spotted out the fact that he placed down a ward, so are there sentries on the courier? Nope, just a teleport scroll, so that might set up Ehome for later, but right now, they're giving even more gold to an Anti-Mage. They're giving even more gold to Queen of Pain as well. And they're gonna lose the tier 1 tower here.
Yeah, they did, however, get the top tower, which is good. They look like they want to defend. They are respawning right now, so this could be good. No.
I was already down.
No fortify.
On the side. He's gonna go in, and in fact, he snowball on 2, gets hexed up. He doesn't actually have help, but he's being left alone. Bloodseeker is zoning him out in the back. Yeah, he's still alive. Needs 5 heroes more or less to finally bring him down. That'll enable the rest of DK to just get the hell out, but it was an odd little fight. I think if Queen of Pain were to jump in there, they could have easily picked off the Zeus and the Lion. But with a Bloodseeker zoning them with their blood right, don't really want to commit too much, I guess.
It's kind of weird not seeing Blademail on a Bloodseeker. He's going for the Sengen Yasha rush, but
oh, they got rush, there's a charge here. They were smoked up. Black is going to be the target here. Should be able to blink out momentarily, even as Shell Grave preemptively. But still being controlled up here. Even more control up. There's a Hex, and it will bring him down.
That was a way too early Shell Grave.
That
was premature, to say the least.
Yeah, there's actually a lot of control between these heroes. I mean, Spiritbreaker himself, the bashes, then he has a line with the stun and a Hex. And then Piao on the Storm Spirit here with that pullback. Now they're gonna
top
go again,
lane.
That's a charge onto top. YCYK, he should be in a similar kind of position if they can catch up in time. Decides to fight, and that was a mistake here. Does not get out in time. Two pickoffs on the two most farmed heroes here on the Radiant side. That puts Bloodseeker straight on top, who does die in the bottom lane to rest of DK's lineup, so maybe we're talking too soon, but yeah, it's Ehom starting to put things together right now.
Yep, they're looking pretty good. Storm Spirit's on the comeback. And Anti-Mage is doing fine, working up to the Vlads first.
Very effective item for just for farming once more, right? Just being able to sustain inside the jungle, even against larger stacks.
Kind of helps him man fight. If he gets ruptured, still he'll take a lot of damage though. Normally can't man fight unless you have the grave, and the graves are gonna have to be timed better this game.
Yep, that's for sure. Scouting ult comes out from Ehom. What DK do have though is even more mobility on the heroes now. Tusk had a really good start, obviously. He was out. I think he recently finished up this Blink Dagger. Speaking of Blink Daggers, Lion picks his up as well. So that last series of events benefiting Ehom a little bit more than DK just because of the deficit that they had from the early game. But now, really strong initiation, not just with the Spirit Breaker coming in, not just with the Storm Spirit jumping in, but also with the Blink Hex, which is pretty much instant. And something that you can work off quite nicely with the rest of your mobility.
Are they gonna smoke
it? Looks like they're looking for a smoke, but then Zeus just dies. Blown up by the Lina, it looks like, yeah. Now there's a smoke on the Kura, it looks like they're waiting for Lion as well.
What's going BKB? BKB Bloodseeker, tired of all the, I guess, the magic damage, the lockdown. It is very scary, and I do think Bloodseeker should get a BKB this game.
Should he get this early, though? I mean,
I don't know. I guess he already has the Midas that's helping him farm. He's got the Yasha for the extra movement speed and the attack speed.
Oh, and splitting off Black. Almost running into these two heroes there. They have plenty of control to keep him safe. Oh, to keep him locked down until Piao gets here. Have to be careful. Ehom is setting up on the high ground. Oh, Black going to farm. But the rest of his team is there as well. Luobo too, with the shallow grave at the ready. They know something's up. Scouting out with the eye shards, and nothing will happen for the time being, but what will happen is that Ehom will take the rest of this jungle, restricting Anti-Mage's farm as much as they can. Still hanging around. Pine placed the ward up on the high ground here with a Blink Dagger of it. Yeah, setting themselves up for success here, using their mobility against what DK has right now.
Yep. He's only had one death so far since he's gotten his Battle Fury. It's pretty good. He's got his Vlads up. It's really hard to play against a Spirit Breaker and a Storm Spirit, because you can't creep skip waves, and sometimes they'll have aggressive wards in your jungle. You can get charged at any minute and zipped on. So far he's been playing really good, and they've been dodging.
Yep.
What are they going to do now, though? They're just going to continue pushing top, but they're going to smoke behind.
That's a good point that you made. I mean, oh, hang on. But middle lane, Piao, can they lock him down further? He has Pavoka in the back, does have a Laguna Blade available. They will use it. Spirit Breaker comes in. Black is here too, though, now. SB all alone. Again, against the Wolf Pack. Goodbye. All spells and will thrown into him, so it's two free pickoffs, really. Nice little pincher movement there with half of the team coming up from the top and one or two teleporting in. But yeah, about that Anti-Mage, good point that you made. With a playstyle, with adapting to that, to the charging potential from the Spirit Breaker and the like. I mean, whenever they don't know where Ehom is, they keep the Anti-Mage close to the rest of the team. Just farming up the enemy jungle when they were pushing tier 1 there on top, for example. Just to keep him safe and be able to react to just ensure that he survives and farm. May not be as efficient, but in the long run, probably the better way to go, especially if they net some, if they give some opportunities like their team fight, and now turning that into Roshan too, that'll keep him safe for sure.
Oh, they gave Anti-Mage the Aegis here, so maybe he can play a little bit more aggressive in farming, but still has to be careful. I think they have enough lockdown to kill him twice if he's out alone. I thought they might give it to the Queen of Pain, but I think it's better for AM if he is on the front line sieging, you know, the tier 2 towers, because that looks like that could be their next objective. But you normally don't want to go tier 2s until you have your anti-mage with the Manta style.
Oh, they want to go for a Stormsplit though. He's silenced up and thinks of Queen of Pain. There's a nice little ultimate onto Captain Fear. Still not dead though. Now he finally is. But Doc 7 in the back here. Then not only Shadow Grave, not even needed here. As Doc will get blown up, but Black, he's still going here. He used the Aegis, 4 heroes down. I don't even know how this happened. But now Zeus up top will make an ultra kill streak for the Queen of Pain, all people. Putting that haste through.
That was on Bloodseeker.
To work.
He started running away, and Anti-Mage just hit him 3 times and healed with Vlad's.
Oh no.
It's really weird, to say the least.
Well, weird and not really too good for EOM, as they're gonna lose the tier 2 off of that as well. Kind of scared to look at the grass, but I think at this point we have to. Yeah, 10,000 is the advantage now for Team DK. 12,000 and more in terms of experience, and a prime position to take this game now. That Bloodseeker has not had too big of an impact in these fights. Same for the Spiritbreaker, really. I mean, they did make some things happen, but not enough by far. Even that Storm Spirit didn't necessarily have a bad early game, apart from that kill that he gave up and before the creep spawn, but Storm Spirit is a hero that's really hard to play from behind on. If the rest of your team is also not doing particularly well.
Yeah, he kind of needs to have the Bloodstone and then kind of group up and get, you know, those charges up, get a little bit more farm, get your next item, and then you're looking pretty good. But he still hasn't gotten his first item. 25 minutes in the game. It'll come out now.
Yep.
And maybe they can make something happen now, but it's a little bit too late. They've got BKB on Queen of Pain. They've got Manta Style on the Anti-Mage. Just looking really good. And when your Tusk is getting away because he has a Blink Dagger, oh, Lion.
Gonna go here. YCYK actually going up to the high ground. Not quite sure. Oh, now Man fight up against Piao. Shows off the BKB. And that'll make Piao think twice about it. Black right in the middle of it. Doesn't have the Aegis anymore, but it doesn't seem to care. Doc is gonna be the prime target here. BKB also from Bloodseeker. He tries to battle up against the Queen of Pain. That's a good pickoff, but now he has to run away. Because Black was working away at it. Meanwhile, on the other side of the fight, they do get the Lina here and now get out. 2-for-2 trades so far, but Black's not done yet. He's still full health, full mana, low cooldown on the blink, and that Stormsword doesn't have too much to play with. Plenty. Oh, maybe not! Maybe not to get him out as XSS gets it with the. With the blink and the ice shards. But yeah, nice and nice. Black didn't have the his ultimate available anymore to just insta kill the Stormsword, but. He sets him down, down the playing field again. Bloodstone just picked up, but down to 6 charges, and that's Manta Style down for the Intermage. Even though they got the Queen of Pain, which was a great pickup, it's still just getting worse and worse for EHOM.
Yeah, Queen of Pain kind of ran extra too, like, help me, help me.
Yeah.
Probably should have stood and man fought. That's all you can really do when you're ruptured. What can she... Yeah. There is a potential way to blink away at max range, and if you move, you can not take any damage from Rupture. Sometimes it's really hard to do, but I think it's possible. And he already used his blink aggressively, so he couldn't blink out immediately, and that's probably what he was thinking. But Queen of Pain, what should he go for? Let's see, what should you get, YCYK? I just think of CTY when I see C's.
Yeah, it's kind of so. Oh, there's a fight. And Snowball comes out after Doc 7 is way too deep. Just gets blown up by the Laguna Blade. That started off as a support Lina, but looking at her items, you wouldn't really think that. It's a Yule Scepter and working on a BK. On an Aghanim Scepter, sorry. And he almost has it. It only needs 100 more gold. Actually, yeah, 100 more gold. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. That's a scary prospect as well. I mean. It's almost level 3 Laguna Blade with that Aghanim Scepter. And a pretty good timing, especially for a support. Everyone's just doing well on DK and EHOM. They're starting to run off map control. That tier 2 will fall. Next one on the list will probably be that tier 2 top that's already down below half health. And EHOM, well, they actually fight. What? What? Why? Do you see this down in the Iranian jungle?
Yeah, I'm not too sure. And then
Zeus.
This is just the tilt.
Yeah.
Tilt factor.
Going
making
forward,
so many plays.
Yeah, it has to be tilt. I mean, Co-op has a BKB. What do you do as a storm against it? He didn't even zip out after the fact. It's a little bit weird what they were trying to accomplish there, but... Well... DK. They hold all the cards right now. They can go for whatever they like, really. How's Black doing? Yeah, he's going for the butterfly now. Felt like a minute ago he got the Manta Star, and now with the Eagle Song already on him. Queen of Pain goes for Shivas, it looks like. I'm just looking to tank up, control it a little bit more. Maybe Nocturne, what do you think?
For Lina?
For Queen of Pain.
You know, I like Lotus Orb in this situation. Just because they have so much single target abilities, like you have Rapture, Charge, Hex, Stun, even Lightning Bolt, plus Vortex, so... Ton of targetable spells that can be reflected, but yeah, I think next best option is just to go for the Shivas. Get that get that armor for the Bloodseeker that's always attacking you. And... No, he's going AC.
No, AC,
Ever,
okay.
Right. Ever, right.
Well, it's still armor for against the Bloodseeker, right? So you have that. And it also helps them push and actually go high ground. Just being able to chip away at the buildings just that more quickly, so it's... Shows that they know that they have an advantage right now, and they want to use it to go high ground before anything happens. Or maybe just get another pick. I see a nice double stun will stop that from happening for the time being, and I will be able to TP out, but... Roshan, not quite up yet. Should be in a couple of moments' time, though. Even though the clock isn't showing it, I do have a feeling that this is broken too, since Reborn.
Yeah, okay. It has been. I think it's kind of different where it shows you. Now, I don't know.
For me, it's not showing any movement at all, right? That's the thing. Just frozen
yeah,
at time.
It's really slow. It moves really slow now.
Oh, yeah, I guess it does. Oh, well, we'll find out sooner or later. As DK, they're setting themselves up around that pit. So they're looking to secure that next. E-home. It's kind of a do-or-die moment for them right now.
Pretty much die. No, just kidding. There's yeah. I'm trying to think of ways back into this game for them. Like, they don't have any really big AoE teamfight. Oh, they have these pickoffs, though. Queen of Pain.
But the BKB will put a stop to that here. Line bursts it down straight off the bat with a couple more right clicks here. And yeah, that's the initiation already squandered now. Stormspin has to get the hell out. Black is ruptured, but don't think he really cares. He just waited out the rest of the team. Pushing out a lot of damage here. Lina yields himself up to the air to nice some of the damage. Shadow Grave comes out to keep him safe. Dark comes in from the low ground here with a charge, but... Yeah, now they can just keep chasing here with all the blinks that they have. There's a snowball here onto the Stormspin and back. No mana to play with, and one last wipe on the Antimage will secure the kill. Dark trying to do what he can, and now... Actually... Queen of Pain, very low on health, will fall. But that's the only casualty of war that they have right now, and Doc might not even make it out. They will see him. They do not. What is that? Snowball didn't even render for me there. It's hilarious. Yeah. But he does get out in time, so make it a 2-3-for-1 trade. Including the lion, and only the Queen of Pain once again.
And when you're killing a Storm Spirit every time and he's not getting the charges, that's another plus one.
Yeah,
so it's kind of like a 4-for-1 trade.
Yeah, he's 2-9-7 right now. Storm Spirit. And... Does it feel good? I can't believe it does. Not for him, anyway.
Yeah, it's almost like out of reach right now, it feels, this game. It's kind of like, alright, well, Bloodseeker, you're going to have to carry us, but... How far this Antimage is.
It's a Bloodseeker who went Midas early on, so he didn't get too many kills in the early game. And what is a Bloodseeker really going to give you? I mean, generally falls off in late game, but especially if you don't have an early game, right? Boboka here, they might get this pick off here, but never mind. There's the Shellgrave coming out just at the right time, and it's the rest of his team coming in with the Snowball across the entire field here. They will stop at the Zeus as they finish off the Bloodseeker. Finger of Death comes out to finish off the Lina, but that's about all they're gonna get here. Triple kill for the Antimage. Piao, he stands up for the moment. Should be able to get the hell out. Yeah, like not quite in
Chase him all the way.
Time.
Chase him. No.
Yeah, they're probably just gonna wait for the creep wave and kill off the tower now. Another great team fight. They lose one, They get three, so it's like one step ahead and three steps back for Ehome.
That's just Anti-Mage up to 3.4k gold now, and he's going to talk about it a little bit earlier. Lina, when he's fourth on the net worth, higher than your mid as a support, it just feels like it's over.
Yeah.
I don't like calling games, but...
Sometimes you just have to, right?
It's just Storm Spirit is way too far behind. He needs to have a BKB right now. He needs a BKB. Lincolns won't even help this game because... they really need to stop the Yules and all the magic damage that's coming out. But even if you have a BKB, Lina's just gonna Ag Scepter you, pure damage through BKB, pure damage to Queen of Pain ulti, and then Anti-Mage is probably gonna have an Abyssal soon.
Yep. Instead he's... I'm not quite sure if he should even finish off the Orchid. He has the Oblivion Staff, but that Orchid would be great like 20 minutes ago. Or 15 minutes ago at least, but now it's just way too late. A couple of steps behind all the heroes. I mean, the only thing they could come back is if DK just suddenly starts to not 5 men anymore and just have heroes one by one all over the map. And that's where Ehome can still get the kills, right? But if they find isolated targets, they have plenty of ways to just keep locking them down between the Storm Spirit, between Junior Spirit Breaker, just 17%ing everything, and the Lion. It's not like they have bad control. Problem with that is most of that is single target control. And most of that doesn't really give you much if the target you go on is just gets shallow graved and then the rest of the team just smacks you over. And this is the way the DK has been playing so far. They kept relatively close together for the most part, just to ensure that whenever Ehome comes in at them, they're ready to fight. And they're ready to make a really, really good trade out of it.
Ever since the butterfly has been up on the Anti-Mage, they have nothing to stop him, nothing to even really hit him. He's got a lot of magic resistance, naturally, and then this Bloodseeker.
He's actually dead right now. There's a punch up in the air. Pops the BKB, but barely, not enough to actually bring him down for some reason. But YCYK does come in with another right click to finish him off. No buyback on him either, so... is there anything that can really stop DK just taking everything right now? I don't think there is.
Nah, that's it. That pick off sealed it.
All right. Not the ideal way to end the game, but sometimes you just have these kind of snowballs that happen. And, well, they go and get the Tuskers all alone at the same time, but it still takes them quite a while before he has to make it work. And they lose their entire mid-racks in the meantime. And even with Tusk down, they don't really have a reason to stop going forward here. Piao low on mana even. And Black, do they recognize that? Does he just... there we go. Oh, a Glimmer Cave actually just in time to keep him safe, but... just a cute little play in the end. They still get the Zeus. The rest of them... still getting the hell out. YCYK with the ultimate completely and without an axe. It's a little bit more blunder than it normally would be, but at the same time... it doesn't matter. Nothing really matters right now for DK anymore. They can just play as the oldest they want. They're so far ahead that there's no way to punish them. I mean, look at Anti-Mage, sitting at 27k net worth. Now, Piao, goodbye. Ehome Noah too, wouldn't be surprised to see the GG sooner rather than later. There it is. Yep. That was game 2, folks. DK took them a little while longer in game 1. They didn't have quite that early game start in the last game, but this game looked a little bit different. They came out strong early. Spirit Break and Bloodseeker. With some questionable item builds here and there, and not having the impact against DK's game sense, positioning, and reactions. Yep, snowball off of that. Anti-Mage. As a figure out there, 12-1 and 11, his final score. Yeah, Ryu, your thoughts about this game?
Yeah, kind of the itemization Bloodseeker. I think he should have went Blade Mill early on. I don't know if he really needed to have a Midas. He needed to cast Rupture before 15 minutes, though. That was for sure. He needed to have maybe 3 or 4 good ganks. And you can even go mid on the Queen of Pain still, and it'd be really effective and gank her or anywhere. And Spirit Breaker couldn't just be anywhere on the map. That's the whole point of picking this lineup. You cannot sit back and just do your own thing. Sure, they had really greedy supports in the Zeus and Lions, so they were kind of far back. And then with Storm getting crushed middle, nothing went well for them except for the Spirit Breaker and Bloodseeker. So those two kind of needed to step it up, make a lot of pressure in the early game, but it didn't happen, and it was just like an easy win for DK, it looked like, after the 20-minute mark.
All right, and with that, we'll end the broadcast for now. Next match here in the ESL1 qualifiers will be a North American match, Complexity versus Team Fire. That'll happen in 4.5 hours with your trusted normal joint Dota casters instead of a scrub like me hopping in at last minute. Once again, also sorry for the technical issues early on. I think this game 2 should have been much more smoother. But yeah, Rybos, thank you very much for co-casting and helping out and making sure that
thank
at least
you.
One guy on the stream knows what he's talking about and makes sense. So,
not me.
So, if people want to find you, where can they do that?
They can find me over on Twitter, twitter.com/RyWarsDota. And yeah, it was my pleasure. It was fun. It's quick games. I'm kind of tired now, though.
Yeah.
Man, casting Chinese Dota, I'm not saying it's boring. It's just that my whole time zone is off, and I just feel tired now.
I know the feeling, man. I know the feeling. It's for me with SEA Dota sometimes, or old stories. Once again, thank you very much for joining me co-casting, and also thank you very much for watching. Go ahead, follow Ryu on Twitter, and if you're already at it, you can follow me as well at Drag and Drop Dota. And yeah, I'll see you next time, maybe.